गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडेज टॉपिक इज सुपर पोजिशन प्रिंसिपल. नाउ वी डिड द सुपर पोजिशन प्रिंसिपल इन क्लास 11th ऑल्सो. इट्स लाइक सेम. सपोज यू हैव अ चार्ज क्यू, यू हैव अ चार्ज क्यू दैट इज सराउंडिंग बाय द नंबर ऑफ चार्जेस Q1, Q2 एंड सो ऑन, Q1, Q2 एंड सो ऑन. नाउ इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट द नेट फोर्स ऑन दिस चार्ज क्यू नॉट because of the other forces, what you are going to do? You are going to simply add the forces on Q0 due to Q1 plus force on Q2 Q0 due to Q2 and Q3 and so on. That means, agar aapko suppose force Q0 per, sorry, charge Q0 per Q1, Q2, Q3 or number of charges jo iske surrounding mein, unki wajah se force nikalni hai. So what you will do? You will simply add the force on Q0 due to Q1 plus force on Q0 due to Q2 plus force on Q0 due to Q3. Q0 पर Q1 की वजह से फोर्स, Q0 पे Q2 की वजह से फोर्स, Q0 पर Q3 की वजह से फोर्स एंड सो ऑन. इन सब का नेट क्या निकलेगा? यू विल सिंपली ऐड द वेक्टर सम ऑफ दीज ऑल फोर्सेस. इज सिंपली ऐड मींस ओनली वेक्टर सम. दिस इज अ वेक्टर, ओनली द वेक्टर सम ऑफ दीज ऑल फोर्सेस. नाउ वी विल डू सम क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड अपॉन द सुपर पोजिशन प्रिंसिपल. सपोज नाउ व्हाट इज गिवन टू यू? सपोज इक्विलेटरल ट्रायंगल इज गिवन टू यू. The three charges 1 microcoulomb, 2 microcoulomb and -3 microcoulomb are placed at A, B, C, three corners, and this is an equilateral triangle. Now what you have to find out? You have to find out what is the magnitude of net force acting on a charge -3 microcoulomb which is lying at point C. You have to find out the net charge on -3 microcoulomb due to charge on A and due to charge on B. Now what is given to you? What is charge given at point A? This is Q1 is given to you, 1 microcoulomb. It is micro means 10^-6, so it will be 1 × 10^-6 coulomb. Another charge Q2 is given to be 2 microcoulomb, that is 2 × 10^-6 coulomb. And another charge Q3 is given, that is -3 microcoulomb, 3 × 10^-6 coulomb. Now what else is given to you? It is given to you this is an equilateral triangle and the side of triangle is given to be 4 cm. Now it is in coulomb, so you have to convert centimeter into meter. So what it will come? About 4 × 10^-2 meter. Now you have to find out the force on charge Q3 due to Q1. That means you have to find the charge on -3 microcoulomb due to 1 microcoulomb. Now force on charge Q3 on due to Q1, you will write it as a F31 vector. See, I am writing force on Q3 due to Q1. Force on Q3 due to Q1. What it will come? 1/4 pi epsilon naught Q3 upon R square. What is Q1 given? 1 × 10^-6. What is Q3 given? 3 × 10^-6. You will write the magnitude of these charges. Minus sign will not come here. Upon R square. What is the distance between Q1 and Q3? What is the difference between distance between Q1 and Q3? This is how much? 4 cm is given to you. So you will write 4 × 10^-2 cm, and you will find out 16.88 newton. And this is force is a vector quantity. You need to find out its direction first. This is -3 microcoulomb. Now you will consider the charge with the polarity. This is -3 microcoulomb and this is 1 microcoulomb. They are unlike charges, so what they will do? They will attract. So this is an attractive forces. F31 will point out from C to A. From C to A, that means it will act along the CA vector. Now you are supposed to find out the force on Q3 due to charge on B, that is 2 microcoulomb. Again, you will apply the formula 1/4 pi epsilon naught Q2 Q3 upon R square. That means 9 × 10. What is the value of 1/4 pi epsilon naught? 9 × 10^-9 newton. Q2, that is 2 × 10^-6 into Q3, that is 3 × 10^-6 upon distance ka square, that is 33.75 newton. Now what is the direction? See here, this is again negative charge, this is positive charge. They are unlike charges. One is of negative polarity, another is of positive polarity. What they will do? They will attract each other. So it will act along a line this, that means CV. Now you have two forces on Q3 due to Q1 and Q2. One is acting along a line, that is CA vector, CA, and another is acting along a line CB. Now that means you have one force here, another force here. How to find out the resultant of these two forces? You know that parallelogram law, complete the parallelogram with the help of this. This is the resultant. Diagonal of the parallelogram, which is originating from the initial point, common point. What is the common point? These two. This is the common point. From here the diagonal comes, yes or no? So this is the resultant by using the parallelogram law. Now what parallelogram is law says? Resultant is equal to first force ka square, second force ka square, 2AB into cosine of angle between them. Now what is the F31? F31 is the first force. And what is B? B is F32, that is the second force. So you will write it as a F31 square A square, F32 square B square, 2F31, F32 into cos of angle. What is the angle? As it was given in the question, it is an equilateral triangle. So what is the angle given? Angle is given to be 60 degrees. So you will write it here as a cos 60 degree and you will solve it. The answer will be 44.65 Newton. Where it will lie? It will lie perpendicular. See, it is cutting this AC. When you will produce it further, it is cutting the AC. So it is perpendicular to the line joining A and B. So what I have written, it is perpendicular to the line joining A and B. Perpendicular, this is perpendicular to the line joining A and B. Okay. Now next is same the question based upon the Coulomb's and superposition principle. You have four charges, 3 microcoulomb, minus 4 microcoulomb, 3 microcoulomb and again minus 4 microcoulomb. This is very important question. They are located at the corners of square ABCD. ABCD. They are lying at the corners of these. Find the force on a charge 1 nanocoulomb which is placed at the center. This is the center of the square where the diagonals are getting intersect. Where the diagonals are intersecting, that is the center point. So here you have placed a charge 1 nanocoulomb. What is the force on this 1 nanocoulomb because of the charges lying at A, B, C and D? This is the question you have to find out. Now, first you should know. Now, for Coulomb's law, we know the formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon root. Two charges multiplied by distance ka square. That means if you want to find out the force on this, you need to find out the distance. So you must know the distance between the charge Q naught and the charge lying at A, B and C and D. Now see, the charge Q naught is lying at equidistance from A, B, C and D. Equal distance is there. So you will find out this distance. How to find out this distance? Now see this triangle ACD. Can we apply the Pythagoras on this? AD square plus DC square is equal to AC square. So with the help of this you will find out. Now what is it given to you? It is given, side is given to be 20 centimeters. So this is 20 square plus 20 square. Under root of this, what will come? 20 root 2. So what is the diagonal length? 20 root 2, but you need to find out this much distance. So how you will find out this much distance? This is the half of AC. So L by 2. Suppose this is L. This total is L. So this is AC. AC is R, which is equal to L by 2. 20 root 2 by 2. That is 10 raised to 10 root 2 centimeter. Put the value of root 2. That is 1.414. So when you will solve this and convert it into meter, 14.1 centimeter. Convert it into meter. This is 14.1 into 10 raised to a minus 2 meter. Now, we have to find out the force on Q naught due to the charge on A, that is 3 microcoulomb. So what is the force on Q naught due to charge on A? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q naught QA upon distance square. What is the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught? 9 into 10 raised to power 9. What is the value of Q naught? 1 into 10 raised to power minus 9. What is the value of QA? That is 3 microcoulomb means 3 into 10 raised to power minus 6. And what is the distance given to you? 14.1 10 raised to a minus 2 meter whole square. When you will solve this, what will come? This will come. Now how to find out the direction? See, this is positive charge, this is positive charge. What they will do? They will repel. They will repel means they will act along this line. They both are repelling each other. So what is the force, direction of force? F naught A, this line, that is along PC. Now you have to find out the force on Q naught due to the charge on B. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q naught qb upon r square. Now what is given to you? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 into 10 raised to power 9. Q naught is 1 nanocoulomb, that is 1 into 10 raised to power minus 9. QB is given to be 4 into 10 raised to power minus 6. And distance is 14.1 into 10 raised to power minus 2 whole square. When you will solve this, 1.81 newton. Now again the direction. The force on Q naught due to Q. What is the, this is positive, this is negative charge. They will attract. They will attract like this. So F naught B will act along like this. That is along PB. Along PB. Now you need to find out the force on Q naught due to QC. Force on Q naught due to the charge on C, that is 3 microcoulomb. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q naught QC upon R square. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 into 10 raised to power 9. Q naught is given to be 1 into 10 raised to power minus 9. And QC is 3 into 10 raised to power minus 6 upon distance square. So this value will come similar to this. It is similar to this. But direction C. This is positive, this is again positive. So they will repel. Where it will act? It will act along a line. This, that is, they are repelling. So it will act along a line along PA, along PA vector. Similarly, the force on Q naught due to Q, due to the charge on D, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q naught QD upon R square. What is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught? That is 9 into 10 raised to power 9. What is the value of Q naught given? Q naught is 1 nanocoulomb, 1 into 10 raised to power minus 9. And QD, it is given to be minus 4 microcoulomb. Minus sign you will avoid. So 4 microcoulomb means 4 into 10 raised to power minus 6 upon distance square. When you will solve this, 1.81 newton. It is similar to this. The value is same. See. But direction, how to find out the direction? This is positive, this is negative. They are unlike charges, so they will attract. So where they will attract? They will act along a line PD. They will act along a line PD. Now see, F naught B and F naught D, they are equal and opposite. F naught B and F naught D, they are equal in magnitude but in opposite direction, PB and PD. So they will cancel out each other. Similarly, F naught A and F naught C, F naught C is acting along this and F naught C is acting along this, and one's magnitude is 1.36 into 10 raised to a minus 2, 3, and same here 1.36 into 10 raised to a minus 3, but they are acting along different line. One is PA and long is PC. They are equal and opposite, so they will also cancel out. So F naught A and F naught C, F naught A and F naught C, they are equal and opposite, so net force is 0. F naught B and F naught D, they are equal and opposite, so net force is 0. So the total net force is on a charge 1 nanocoulomb that is placed at a center Q naught, placed at a center, the net force is 0. Now we will do another question based upon the same. Suppose, now what is given to you in the question? Suppose you have 4 point charges Q, Q, Q and Q. They are placed at the corners given in the figure. You have to find out the resultant force on the charge Q. Now see here. Force on Q at A due to, first you will find out the force on charge capital Q lying at A due to the charge Q lying at point B. Now what is the value? Suppose it is F1. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into Q, Q into Q upon distance square. Now what is the distance given to you? The side is given to be A, A square. Along, what is the line? They are similar charges, so they will repel, they will repel. They are going to repel each other. So it will act along this line. Say I have marked. This is acting along this line. F1 is acting along AX. I have marked it like this. Now you have to find out the force on Q due to the force on, due to the charge Q lying at C. What will come? 1 by 4 plus, by epsilon naught Q into Q, that is Q square upon distance ka square. This distance is there between them. So what is the distance? How to find out distance? Again, you can find out the distance by using the Pythagoras. This is A, this is again. So this is A square plus A square, under root of this, this is root 2A. When you will solve this, root 2A, put the values, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by 2A square. What is the direction acting along it? What is the direction acting along it is? See, this is positive, this is positive. They will repel each other. So what is that? They will repel each other. So where it is acting? F2 is acting along this way. So I have taken F2 is acting along AE. I have marked it. Previous it was F1 is acting along AX and F3 is acting along AE. Now force on charge Q due to this charge, small charge q lying at point D. Now what is the force? Suppose I have taken it as F3, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught qq by a square. Qq by, what is the distance between these two? A, so it is a square. Now what is the direction? They are similar charges, again they will repel, they will repel. So where it will act? It will act like this, it will act like this along Ay. So how many forces are there? One is F1, another is F2, another is F3. Now forget about this first. You will find out the resultant of, forget about this one first, find out the resultant of F1 and F3. See F1 and F3. F1 is lying here and F3 is lying here. How to find out the resultant of this? This is 90 degree. By using the parallelogram law, what you can do? A square plus B square, 2AB cos theta. Cos 90 is 0. So last term will be deleted. So what is left? R is equal to root of A square plus B square. That means F1 square plus F3 square. Put the values and you will come to this value. Similarly, now see where it will act. It will act along the diagonal starting from that common point. So what is the resultant? Resultant of these two is F dash. It will act along this line. But already along this line, there was another force, F2 lying. So what is the net force? One is F dash, another is F2. So what is the net force on Q was lying here? What is the net force? Q was here. What is the net force on Q? Because of the, they are acting in the same direction. So what you will do? You will simply add them. So this is F dash and F2 is the net force. F2 is this much and F dash is this much. And find out, this is the resultant. You will simply add them and this is the resultant. It will act along which line? AE I have written. Where is AE? This is AE. This is A. This is AE. Yes, this is AE. Okay. Thank you.